Find effective spring constant of the as shown in figure. Here given that all the springs are identical springs. All the springs are identical springs. Each spring force constant is K. Now see here, you are given three springs. Each spring force constant as K. They are connected as shown in figure. Then what is the effective force constant of the system? See here, to draw this one, to find effective force constant, what, let us assume that these two springs are in parallel. In parallel combination, effective force constant is equal to Nk if all the springs are identical. If not identical, then Kp is equal to K1 plus K2 plus K3, so on, like that we have to assume. In series combination, effective force constant for two springs Ks is equal to K1 into K2 divided by K1 plus K2. This is the formula. Now see here, these two springs are first connected as parallel. So that these two are connected in parallel combination, effective spring constant is 2K. So when we replace these two springs by single spring, this 2K, and this one more spring is there, that spring let us connect here, this is K. Okay, now these two springs are, this diagram simplified as like this. Now see, these two springs are, in which way is there now? In series combination is there. So let us take K1 as 2K. And K2 as K. Now substitute in series combination this from this formula. K is equal to K1, how much we taken? 2K. K2 is how much? K divided by K1 is 2K plus K2 is K. So in numerator we are getting 2K square divided by 2K plus K, 3K. Now by cancelling K, we are getting 2 by 3K. In series combination, we have to get effective force constant lower than lowest force constant. Here, see here, 2K and K, these two are in connected in series. Among these two, lowest force constant is K. And we are getting effective force constant lower than lowest K we are getting. Lowest force constant, 2 by 3 is lower than K, then. So that less than 2 by 3 we got. Less than 1K we got. Let us go to second problem. Second problem, try panla. Seringla? Seripa. Let us take this one as a rope. Let us connect spring. This is one spring. And this is another two springs. And one more spring I am connecting here. To this I am connecting block. Here each spring force constant as K, taken as K. Then what is the effective force constant of the system? So first what we have to do? We have to combine these two are in parallel. So if you are taking these two are in parallel, this spring we are taking as it is like this K. And this one parallel combination means how much it comes for this spring, 2K it comes. And here one spring is there, that is K. Now all these are in series is there. These three are in series. In parallel combination, in series combination, effective force constant is equal to reciprocal sum of individual force constant. So 1 by K plus 1 by 2K plus 1 by K. Now what is the LCM for this? 2K. So here what happens? 2 plus 1 plus 2. So how much we are getting? 5 by 2K. So 1 by Ks is equal to 5 by 2K. So Ks is equal to 2K by 5. Ks is equal to 2K by 5. Let us solve another problem. This is first spring. Next, we are taking two springs. We are connecting parallel and a series to the first spring. And we are taking again three springs. Those three springs are connected in parallel and connected to previous springs. Now each spring force constants are taken as K. What is the force constant of the combination of the system? What is the force constant of the combination of the system? Now we simplify and redraw these diagrams. Here this K we are writing as K, directly as a K. Now these two K's are, this K and K are in parallel, so that in parallel combination direct sum we have to take 2K. And now these three springs are in parallel, so that these three springs are, if we connect those three springs, effective spring constant equal to 3K. Now all these are in series, all these are in series. Now K, 2K, K, 2K, 3K, these all are in series. In series combination, effective spring constant formula is equal to 1 by KS is equal to 1 by K plus 1 by 2K plus 1 by 3K. 1 by K plus 1 by 2K plus 1 by 3K. Now what is LCM here? 6K. So by taking LCM 6 plus 3 plus 2, this is 1 by KX. This 6 plus 3 plus 2 is 11. So 11 by 6K. So answer of the KS is equal to 6K by 11. 6K by 11.